Well, eventually, Catherine and I did work everything out. And I did decorate that giant pumpkin for the Halloween party. And I even made some Halloween posters to advertise the event. But that all happened a year ago. This year, Catherine and I will be celebrating Halloween here in New York. And she's with me today to co-host this last part of my craft show with me. Welcome back, Catherine.
Thanks, Mark. Nice to be here.
It's good to have you here.
Well, great.
This year, I added a little bit to my Halloween decorations in my apartment here in New York. I wanted to show you this ghost that I made using a sheer curtain. And I also made some leaves to hang. So that's what I did this year.
What do we have coming up for the rest of today's show, Mark?
Well, you may remember we had a Twin Peaks contest here on my show. And those that wrote in with the correct answers to the trivia questions get to have 3 minutes of airtime here on my show. And today we have another winner. His name is Tony Gray.
Tony Gray, and I was one of the winners of the Twin Peaks contest that Mark Heskin did on his show. And for my 3 minutes, I decided to share my gift wrapping techniques with you all. And I chose a Twin Peaks theme. Some of the images are from Twin Peaks, and I'd like to show you those now. Well, what I do is I collect a lot of images. I have magazines and a lot of tissue and some pattern books and just other kinds of things, old cards, note cards and things like that. And I think about who it's for, who the gift is going to be for, and how I want to put things together. So I choose some colors. You know, there's a lot of colors in the tissue paper. And for the first one, on the Twin Peaks theme, I found an image of Joan Chen, and I put that was the basic wrap, you know, the under wrap. And then, you know, I had some other paper. I had a picture of a tree and a thing that looked like a plaid flannel shirt, and a little Tyrolean guy there, and just, you know, combine them. It's sort of idiosyncratic, and it's kind of fun. And on the second one, there's a picture of the woman that plays Audrey, Sherilyn Finn. And I didn't have a picture of the Cooper character, so I just got this old Ken doll picture. And there's a fight going on, a barroom brawl. It sort of looks Twin Peaks. You know, again, it's sort of fun, sort of odd. But there's a lot of different combinations and a lot of different things that you can do. You can choose your own. You can choose something that has to do with your friends or some inside joke or whatever.
Right now, I'm going to open up one of the packages that I wrapped previously. This one happens to be on an Asian theme. And I just want to, you know, show you what it looks like when it's open, you know, and how much of a surprise it is. And here it is. Here's the package. It's got some textures on it. And this is for someone, like, maybe someone isn't feeling so bad or they have a lot of problems. And you want to wrap it nicely for them, and you could give them back trouble book, hay fever book, handbook. You know, it could help someone out, make them feel good, and have a happy Halloween.
It was real fun to meet Tony and visit his apartment. One thing in this apartment I wanted to show you is this neat greenhouse that Tony converted into a bedroom. I can only imagine what it must be like to sleep in this bedroom when snow is falling or when it's raining out. It was just a really neat room.
That looks really nice. So, Mark, have you made any TV appearances lately?
Well, yes, I have. Here we can see me on Sally, Jesse, Raphael. I'm with my friend Brian Scott Carr. And the topic on this day was divorced people that still get along with their exes, their ex-spouses, yeah. And here we can see me on Phil Donahue. I'm with my friend John Radwick. And the topic on this day was divorced people who get back together with their exes. And I even asked a question.
Tied his shoes without me at first, you know?
Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie?
You bet.
You are?
You bet I am.
Yeah. You can sure tell I have my own TV show, can't you?
Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie? Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie? Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie? Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie? Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie? Jeannie, is Jeannie still working? Are you still working, Jeannie?
You bet.
You are.
You bet I am.
Yes.
Yes, Lee and I speak together.
Now let's get back to the Halloween theme of today's show. Here's a clip from an earlier episode where I tell you about a pet peeve of mine. Let me show you the scarecrows. I've seen scarecrows, people make scarecrows before. People, I get tired of seeing scarecrows sitting in lawn chairs. People never seem to be able to come up with a design so the scarecrows can stand up. Last year, we drove around town and took a look at some of the Halloween displays in my hometown of Portland, North Dakota. You tell me what you think.
If you take your love from me, my child, I would be a ghost in a little while. I'll be a ghost, 'cause I know I'd die. I would be so blue until eternity. If you ever take your love from me, I'd be a blue ghost, 'cause I need your love. Ghosts come in colors, baby, I'd be blue. A ghost doctor wouldn't know.
While out looking at fall decorations, I also saw another sign of fall. I saw a group of geese flying south for the winter. Here they are up in the air. They come down to North Dakota from Canada, and they stop here to feed once in a while. So here are some geese. Besides my own display, this was the favorite display that I saw. Near this farm out in the country, there was also an old schoolhouse. I thought this was rather nice too.
If you take your love from me, my child, I would be a ghost in a little while. I'll be a blue ghost, 'cause I know I'd die. I would be so blue until eternity. If you ever take your love from me, I'd be a blue ghost, 'cause I need your love. If you take your love from me, my child, I would be a ghost in a little while. I'll
I'll be a bulldog. Cause I know I'd die. I would be so blue until eternity. If you ever take your love from me, I'd be a blue girl. Cause I need your love. Those coming colors, baby, I'd be